Sunday. Because the gospel of the fourth Sunday of Easter always relates one of Jesus' good shepherd sayings, today is a good day to reflect and to be thankful for all the people who have been good shepherds in your faith life, and to pray for all pastors, priests, as well as the vocations for the future of our church. And so we take a moment to welcome the mercy, the forgiveness, and the understanding of God in our lives. Lord Jesus, you are the gate for the sheep, the way to eternal life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the gate for the sheep, the way to true and lasting peace. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the gate for the sheep, the way to union with the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
From the Acts of the Apostles. Then Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice and proclaimed, "Let the whole house of Israel know for certain that God has made both Lord and Christ, this Jesus whom you crucified. Now when they heard this, they were cut to the heart. And they asked Peter and the other apostles, "What are we to do, my brothers?" Peter said to them, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the forgiveness of your sins, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. For the promises made to you and to your children and to all those far off, whomever the Lord our God will call." He testified with many other arguments and was exhorting them, "Save yourselves from this corrupt generation." Those who accepted his message were baptized, and about 3,000 persons were added that day. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. no deceit was found in his mouth. When he was insulted, he returned no insult. When he suffered, he did not threaten. Instead, he handed himself over to the one who judges justly. He himself bore our sins in his body upon the cross, so that, free from sin, we might live for righteousness. By his wounds you have been healed, for you have gone astray like sheep, but you have now returned to the shepherd and guardian of your souls. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The story of the Good Shepherd reminds me of a game I used to play when I was a kid. All right? The idea of a gatekeeper going and coming and searching and finding and following and leading. This game was called Hide and Seek. I'm going to play Hide and Seek for the next 2 minutes. All right? Because maybe some of you have played this game before. We usually had a group of people, and the idea was most of them would scatter, and one person would be hit. And that person had to find the rest of the people before they came to, let's call it, a home base. We're going to use the altar as a home base. And so, the person who was it would hide this way as the other people scattered. He would count to 100. And when they were scattered,
he had to go find them. And so he got up.
The idea is they had to come back to home base before he could find them. And if he did find them, it was a race to home base. So off the person who was it went, looking. He went here and he went there. He went into people's yards. He looked thoroughly through the bushes, around trees. He climbed fences. He went up a hill, came down a hill. They couldn't see him, and he couldn't see them, but somehow he kept his eye on home base. And if they tried to race to home base, he would try to beat them to home base. Eventually, everyone came in. Everyone came in. The idea behind our spiritual life is that we are trying to find God. We're trying to reach home base. We're trying to become closer to God. We pray. We come to Mass. We try to be good people in an effort to find God and to be faithful to the message that God has given us. I have very good news for you. And the good news is this, is that God has already found you. The one that you are looking for, the one that you are searching for, the one that you want to follow, that God has already found you. How has God found you? There are great examples of this in the Easter Gospels and liturgies that we've been celebrating. At one point, as the disciples are huddled in fear in a room, Jesus comes through the door. There are no physical barriers that can stop him. And there are no emotional or psychological barriers that can stand in his way. They are huddled because they are afraid. They're huddled because they're ashamed. When Jesus comes among them, he says, "Peace be with you." He does away with their shame. He does away with their fear. He is there for them as the Good Shepherd. He is there for them as the Merciful One. On another occasion, one of them says, "I've got to put my hands in his side. I've got to touch his hands, okay, the wounds in his hands. I want to know if it's really him." And Jesus says, "Step up. Here's my hands. Here's my side. Do what you need to do. I can handle your doubt. I can handle your fear. I can handle your hesitation. I can handle whatever you throw at me." On another occasion, these two are walking the way and they meet a stranger and they tell the stranger in no uncertain terms that he doesn't know where things are at. And the stranger is the one who really knows where things are at. And he helps them understand. How do they recognize him? How do they really understand him? They understand him when they sit around the table and they eat of the bread that he brings. In much the same way, if you and I understand each other, when we sit around the table, and we break the bread that has been cooked for us, the meal that has been prepared with our family, with our friends. This is who God is. Nothing can stand in the way of God. God is the one who has already found us. He has found us because he loves us. You know, in that first greeting, you can hear
You can hear the words of the first reading in two ways. When Peter says to the people who are asking, well, what are we supposed to do, brothers? He says, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ. Now you can hear that and see that as Peter pointing fingers, okay, at somebody and saying, you did something wrong, you better repent, you better change, you better move your life, you better get it straight. Or we can understand that as Peter energizing the people. Hey, I've got great news for you. Yeah, repent, okay? But Jesus Christ is here for the forgiveness of your sins. Jesus is here, the risen one, for you, okay, to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. And I think that is what Peter does. Peter does not catch people in the act. Peter does not point the finger. But Peter invites people to be caught up in the spirit of the risen one, in the spirit of the one who is alive, and who invites each and every one of us to be alive in that way. And isn't that what it means to be baptized? Isn't that what it means to have a vocation on this Vocation Sunday? Yes, to be ordained. Yes, to be called to religious life. Yes, to men. Yes, to women. Yes, to everyone. Okay? Because we have all been baptized. And that is the essential call of the Christian life. We find it in our baptism, and we move with the power, we move with the energy that God has given to each and every one of us through our baptism in the Holy Spirit. The Good Shepherd, the one whose gate swings both ways, out and in, as a leader and asking us to follow, okay? Showing us the way. Let him be the one who calls each and every one of us deeply today into the life of Christ, into the life of the Spirit. Amen. Amen. Let us pray our Apostles' Creed together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Jesus, the Good Shepherd, is the one in whose wounds we have been healed, and who is the guardian of our souls. Let us now turn to Him with the needs of all the world.
For the Church across the world, on this World Day of Prayer for Vocations, that the Holy Spirit will call forth new vocations, especially in those places where the service of priests and deacons and the witness of religious is in the greatest need. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who lead our country and those running for elected office, that they may put public service above personal or political gain. And for our first responders, military, and allied troops, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our sick in hospitals, in nursing homes, and in their own homes, for the frail aged and those with chronic illness or disability, and for those cut off from families at this time, that they may know that they too are our concern. Held up to God in prayer, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the lost and wounded sheep of our own flock, that they may know the love and care of the Good Shepherd through our efforts, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in need of the Lord's healing, including Father Lawrence Baer, Dick Aldener, Patricia Hands, Michael LaBeouf, Noreen Buckley, Louis R. Vieira, Joanna Wood, Marie Hurton, Agnes Holda, Michelle Michael Oldfield, Esther Redman, James Swam, Louis Garcia, Herb Knoll, Jamie Jones, that the blood of the Lamb offered in his Mass may strengthen and console them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our loved ones who have died and need wait for the Lord no longer, including Marianne Emery, Denise Giovo, James E. Shannon, and Barbara DeMunda, that God may lead the departed souls to springs of life-giving waters and wipe away every tear from the eyes of those who remain here below. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people of the parish for whom this Mass is offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all these intentions and the ones we carry in our hearts, we pray not only through the Lord Jesus, but Mary as we say. Hail Mary.
Full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
His death is our ransom from death,
and in his rising the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the cup, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Children of God.
Spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot, at this moment, receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Thank you. our churches. We look to the weekend of May 30th and 31st as the first opportunity to celebrate the weekend masses in the churches. And before that, on May 11th to the 18th, the church building will be open for private prayer, as well as for what we hope to schedule at that time, opportunity for the sacrament of reconciliation. And then from the 18th of May to the 30th, there will be daily mass in the church, and with no mass on the weekend of that stretch of time, however. We then would go to the 30th, 31st, hopefully to resume our normal schedule. There is a new normal as we embark on the month of May, however. One very first important point is to understand that the obligation for Catholics to attend Mass is lifted until further notice. The crisis of this pandemic has not ended. We're hoping we can work in cooperation with civil and medical authorities to be able to walk into our return rather to our normal life. In the meantime, and while the church is being used in the month of May, the doors of the church will be locked, the side doors will be locked. Only the main door will be an opportunity for people to come in. This is to limit, I'm told, the spread of germs. Of course, the egress will always, an emergency egress is always available at the other doors. Holy water stoops. No water this will be available at this time. We just make the sign of the cross as we enter the church, reminding ourselves that it's indeed we are baptism people. There will be no collection baskets as such. Here at Blessed Trinity, we pass a round basket from hand to hand. We have not quite decided on this detail, but more than likely we will place a collection basket at the exit doors or the entrance door, and people will make their offering at that time. We look to the sign of peace as being done by a bow, a gesture, a verbal greeting, like "May the peace of Christ be with you." Of course, we see, what do you call this, social distancing prevailing throughout the month of May, and that might continue beyond May 31st. Instructions are yet to be given about that. People are encouraged to wear their masks at the church. However, we won't police that item. We will not pull anybody by the ear and say, "Put your mask on." No, none of that, of course not. But an appeal for common sense for the safety of all. Communion will be received only in the hand and with the sacred host, and not with the precious blood of the Lord, again, for obvious reasons. We are invited to sing our hearts out with the music ministry. We are so blessed here to have a wonderful ministry. That will be a call to deeper prayer for us. Confession, as I say, has been scheduled by appointment throughout these last several weeks. That will continue in the month of May, and perhaps after the 11th, we will have assigned hours. You will be notified of the daily mass. There will be no hard copy bulletin out of our deference to the ecosystem that has been stressed by this pandemic. We're trying to save trees and paper. We will simply use, and we're being encouraged to do that by medical authorities. We'll just have the bulletin. Will be in electronic version on our website. That is, in a nutshell, the changes that we are hoping will be a first step, maybe second and third step to return to normal life. In the meantime, we're hoping that once we return to the church for the daily mass, we will live stream from the church also the mass. So the last point I want to make is that this mass here and the live streaming of our mass will continue right through to May 31st. Every day, and we can schedule at 10 and 12. God bless you all. Thank you. And thank you, Richard. Richard, my classmate, we both celebrated our 50th anniversary of priesthood just this past year. We've known each other since 1957. That's a long time. And he got marooned here, actually. He's now, his ministry is to kind of be in touch with the senior members of our province, make sure that they have everything they need. So he stopped at our house because we're all seniors here. And so he did one himself. So he got removed here because he really is more full-time in Attleboro than he is here at Blessed Trinity. But he's been a welcome presence. God bless you all.
My stay may depend on the virus, so you're stuck with me for a while. Okay. Let us stand to receive God's blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us all, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace to love, serve the Lord, and each other.
Thanks be to God.
I pray to St. Michael.
St. Michael, the Archangel. Defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil.
May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host,
by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls.